YouTubers, Budzilla here. I just wanted to show you a quick video of a pressure chamber I made for forming resin casting. So this is it. It's real simple. It was $25. We have a 6-inch PVC threaded end. If you can see, there's actually a cap that threads in there. Then I had notched my workbench out so that that fits right into there. So when I put the cap on, it's easy to, that basically holds it. Now originally I had it just this tall, and this cap would have threaded into right here. But that would just, I found that it wasn't tall enough for what I'm casting, so I added this. And basically what I had to do is use a Dremel and eat away at the threads until this fit in there nice. And then juice it up like with a PVC adhesive. And it works fine. I added some screws. You don't have to do this if you get it good enough. I just wasn't sure, and I always, everything I do is overkill, so I just put 4 screws just to hold it in. And before we go any farther, I'm going to tell you that, you know, if you look on the internet, it says never pressurize PVC. That is a great, great, great bit of advice. However, I'm only using 35 PSI, and all PVC, even the thin-walled PVC, is rated over 100 PSI. So, it will not fail for my situation. So basically, I'm actually casting something right now. And if you look, I've already pressurized it. If you look, something interesting has happened that you're not going to be able to see because my camera blows. Okay, so if you see all those bubbles, so those bubbles would have been in my casting. And like I said, this is a finished cast. So basically what I do is I take the most important piece, which is my seal, because you're not going to be able to do anything without this seal. So this is just a piece of belt rubber that I cut in a circle perfectly, put some holes in it. The holes serve two purposes. One, so I can pull it out. Two, if you don't have those holes in there, you're going to seal your lid to your rubber, and you're only going to pressurize the top part, so that's not going to do you any good. So then I put this on here, spin it around till it's tight. I have a gauge and a standard tire valve stem. I just drilled a hole in there. I think the hole's 3/8. Pulled it through. That seals that right up. Then I have my gauge here, and the gauge is not actually threaded into the PVC. What I did is drill the hole a little bit bigger and use some of this epoxy here and sealed it in with epoxy. That way, if there's a failure, it's not going to be here, you know, it's not going to explode out towards me to, you know, and cause harm. It's just going to either pop this off or leak slowly, which is more likely the case, because again, I'm only using 30 PSI. So I'm going to show you how it works. Let me tighten it down by hand here. Okay, so I can feel that I now have contact with the rubber. Now I'm going to grab my pipe wrench here. And put it on. I'm probably not going to be able to do this with one hand, but you'll get the point. So I'm just going to see, and that's why, because it wants to spin out. Alright, so you know, I'm just going to do that, just to show you. And now I have my compressor under here, which you've seen before if you watch any of my other videos. And I'm going to pressurize it. And again, this is just for demonstration purposes. I've already cast this part. And this is pretty much instant. So once you pressurize it, all the bubbles come up. So you don't have to keep it under pressure. And you'll see I didn't quite put enough pressure on it because it's actually losing air. But it doesn't really matter. So all the bubbles have already come up. It's almost instant. My old one that I made, let me put this back in here, actually had a clear acrylic window here. And as soon as you hit the pressure, as soon as it gets to about 15, you see all the bubbles come to the top. And now it's going to hold this, it'll hold pressure at like 12 PSI, it'll hold for about 15, 20 minutes, which is plenty. Like I said, it's instant, so I could take it out right now, and whatever it's going to do, it has pretty much done. All right, so if you guys have any questions or comments, please leave them below. As always, see ya, and have a great day.